Hi everyone, and welcome to another video. In this one, I will explain you how to create a bootable USB drive for installation of Windows 11 from macOS. There might be various reasons why one would want to do this. Most likely it will be to install Windows 11 on the Mac itself, or to recover or reinstall Windows on a regular PC which no longer works, and no other Windows-based machine is available to create this media at the time. The goal is for this USB drive to be usable on both Macs and PCs. On a Windows machine, you could use the media creation tool, which you can download from Microsoft's website to create a bootable USB drive for installation. Unfortunately, this tool is not available for macOS, so we'll need to do this another way. I did a video earlier on the same for Windows 10. In the meanwhile, I also took some more time to try an experiment to find an easier method, but so far, the same method seems to be still the best. I'll tell you more about that later. One more thing before we start is that I'd like to mention that you can find all what I will discuss here and the commands used in detail on my blog as well. So if you plan to go through this yourself, have a look there. I'll put the link in the description. Let's start the whole process by downloading the Windows 11 ISO. This can be done from Microsoft's website, for which I will also provide a link in the description. As you can see, there are a few options to download it. Windows 11 Installation Assistance, the mentioned Windows Media Creation Tool, and the Windows 11 disk image or ISO. We need a third option to download the ISO. Select the only option that is available from the drop-down, Windows 11 Multi-Edition ISO. Select the preferred language. And then click the 64-bit download. And wait for the download to complete to get the ISO file on your Mac. The download is complete, and we can see the ISO file is in our downloads folder. Next, we will prepare the USB drive which we will use for all of this. You will need one that is at least 8 GB. Insert the drive in your Mac, and then start disk utility. In disk utility, make sure to select Show all devices. As you can see, this shows the full drive now and not only the volume on that drive. On the left side, click on the drive itself and then click on Erase in the top right menu. Here we can give the drive a name. I chose for WinUSB. For the format, which is the file system that we will use on the USB drive, macOS supports both XFAT and FAT32 that are compatible with Windows. As the installation ISO contains a file that is larger than 4 GB, XFAT would sound like a logical choice as FAT32 does not support files over 4 GB in size. Unfortunately, I noticed that having the USB drive with a file system XFAT causes a lot of PCs to not be able to boot from it. Hence, I will still have to go for FAT32. Later, to overcome the issue with the large file, we will need to use a tool called wimlib, which is able to split that file in two parts. For the scheme, we will go for master boot record. Again, this doesn't sound like a logical choice today, but I did try to go through this process while using GUID, which resulted in the installer not being able to find the necessary files during installation. If all looks here like I have it, finally click Erase to complete the process. Our USB drive is now prepared. It's using master boot record as scheme, and we can see that the WinUSB volume is of type FAT32. Now we can start copying data to the USB drive. The source is that ISO file which we downloaded first. So navigate to your downloads folder and simply double-click the ISO to mount it on your Mac. Here we have it. Inside the sources folder, we can see that one large file called install.wim, which we are not able to copy directly to the USB drive. We'll take care of that later. For now, we can copy all remaining files to the USB drive using Finder. The easiest is to open both the mounted ISO and the USB drive in Finder and put them side by side. Left, I have the mounted ISO, right bottom is the USB drive. Then, I typically start by copying all separate files and folder, except for the sources folder, from the ISO to the USB drive. Once that is done, create a new folder on the USB drive and call it Sources. open the folder and do the same on the mounted ISO. Then copy all files from the sources folder on the left, with the exception of install.wim, to the USB drive. Okay, so far things were pretty straightforward, and if it wouldn't be for that large file, we'd be done here. Unfortunately, we have more work to do and need to split the large install.wim file in two parts, smaller than the limit of our file system on the USB drive can handle. To accomplish this, we can use wim-lib. This is a tool that is developed to work with and modify .wim files. The easiest way to get this installed on your Mac is by using Brew or Homebrew. We start by installing that tool. Navigate to brew.sh and, as instructed, copy the command. Open a new terminal window and paste the command which we just copied. Then press Enter to execute it. You will be asked for your password and need to confirm to install the Xcode command line tools. The rest of the Homebrew installation takes some time. In my case, it was around 5-6 minutes, I believe. Once Brew is installed, we can use it to install wm-lib. If you're using an M1-based Mac, you might need to go through an additional step to add Brew to the path before you can use it. Now to install wm-lib, simply type brew install wm-lib, followed by Enter. wm-lib is now installed. We can use it to split the large install.wm file and copy it over to our USB drive. In the same or a new terminal session, we will need to construct the command for that. First, let's list the names of the volumes we have on the system using ls-1/volumes. The first entry we can see here is the name of the mounted Windows 11 ISO. And the third one is our USB drive called WinUSB. We can see the same names in Finder. Top left, which is our ISO with that same name. And bottom right is the USB drive. Back to the terminal. Type wam-lib-imagex, then split, followed by the source path, which is on volumes, then the name of our mounted ISO, /sources/install.wam. You can use tab to complete names to make things easier. The next argument is the destination of the splitted files. So volumes, WinUSB, /sources/install.swim. Last argument is 4000, which is the maximum size to split the files into. So we have wam-lib-imagex, split, the source volume which refers to the mounted ISO, the destination which matches with the USB drive, the path sources/install.swim and 4000 as maximum size. This step can take quite some time as there is a lot of data to be copied to your USB drive, so it largely depends on that one's write speed. Splitting has finished. As you can see, now we have two files created on the USB drive, install.swim and install2.swim. The Windows 11 installer knows exactly how to deal with these and will work just fine. That should be all you need to create a bootable USB drive for Windows 11 installation from macOS. As a final step, now that we have the USB drive completely prepared, let's test if we can boot from it. I'm moving the USB drive to the PC where I want to install Windows 11. Then I'm entering the boot menu. On a regular PC, this is usually done by pressing a key at BIOS time. F9 or F11 is quite common, or, for some older BIOSes, by changing the boot order. On a Mac, you can choose to boot from USB by holding down the Alt key on boot and to select the USB drive from the bootloader. The second entry here is our USB drive. Let's select that one to boot from it. If you would plan to use this USB drive to install Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, which includes Intel-based Macs, then you will need to work around the hardware checks. I did a video on that earlier, for which I will put a card here in case you're interested. After some waiting, we can see the Windows installer, booted from our USB drive, created on macOS, just as we wanted. Thanks a lot for watching, hope this video can help you, and if you have liked it, please put a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments how this worked for you, and don't hesitate to subscribe if you're interested in more of the same. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.